We must encourage African leaders to abandon their obsession with power and unite behind a common and immediate goal of an integrated political system towards one economy and one African state. Africa must have one government, a central economy, and one president. The tragedy of coronavirus gives us an opportunity to unite as a continent to develop out of this crisis a new economy. We must use this time to develop our industry, to develop our healthcare sector, and to develop trade relations. We must go back to the ideas of Gaddafi of an African economy and currency based on mineral wealth of our continent, not imaginary markets. Today, we see the likes of the United States of America printing money without consequences to the value of their currency. This is because they control the markets that determines the value of currencies. They do this without any gold, oil, or valuable mineral resources. We see the United States manipulating international institutions because they want to be the dominant global power. They do this at the expense of nations that have mineral and raw resources. For true freedom, we must unite with progressive international forces to combat imperialist powers. We must unite with Cuba, whose legacy is progressive and shows itself today through its deployment of medical staff and resources across the world to combat the coronavirus. We must emerge from this pandemic with an African economy that will give to the world a new human face. As we commemorate Freedom Day, let us keep in our hearts the less fortunate and those who are marginalized the most in our society. Let us protect one another. Let us protect women and children, the elderly and the disabled. Let us protect Africa and her children and be caring to all of her people. As many of our hard-fought freedoms are denied to us today in combat the spread of the coronavirus, let us all remember that most basic human right is the right to life. To protect this right, let us all remain in our homes and observe the guidelines given to us by our respective governments across the world. Fellow fighters, already in the 1950s, Frantz Fanon wrote about Africa as the wretched of the earth. He located racism directly at the people of African descent to be the greatest and most violent of all oppressions. All people of the world despise Africans. Nothing about Africans invites respect, dignity, humanness, and beauty in the eyes of the world. We represent slavery, underdevelopment, poverty, disease, hunger, suffering, and illiteracy. Everyone thinks they are better than an African. They can meet the worst form of suffering like Holocaust and gulags. They still will see themselves as better than Africans. Meaning, instead of human tragedy making them identify with Africans, they will still think of their own human suffering as better than being an African. Why? Because African is being trapped in a skin color, a body we can never escape. How do you escape being yourself? Such will only lead to self-destruction and permanent self-sabotage. These are our conditions and image in the world. Therefore, a genuine conversation about Freedom Day must reflect on this status of African people. The fact that these conditions have continued long after African continent have declared itself independent and free of colonial rule is a problem. The African body has not attained humanity and dignity in the eyes of itself. even in the eyes of those who inhabit it. It feels like a curse we want to escape, a burden we want to dump. With the global outbreak of coronavirus in Wuhan, China, the black body still found its way to bearing the blame for a virus that never came from its continent. In Guangzhou province, the home to Asia's largest African migrant population, a state-sponsored propaganda has come to blame African migrants for bringing and spreading COVID-19. The local authorities have identified Africa as the source of the largest number of imported COVID-19 cases. Among all foreign cases identified in Guangzhou, 76% are said to be from African countries, including 36% from Nigeria alone. How is it that a virus that originated from China somehow came to be blamed on the black bodies by the same Chinese authorities? In less than 100 days since the first case of coronavirus was reported in Wuhan, authorities in China are saying coronavirus is from Nigeria. The black body is so despised that it must be blamed for any disease anywhere in the world. As a result of this state propaganda, African migrants are being targeted in China, beaten up randomly on the street, not allowed into shopping malls, and evicted from buildings they rent. This tragic development during a time that requires global solidarity already shows you what the world is willing to do in order to put Africa in its rightful place. At the bottom, as an evil continent infecting the whole world with death and diseases. We must not forget that just before the global outbreak of COVID-19, the world was discussing the migrant crisis in Europe, mainly from African continent. Europe, in particular, countries like Italy, France, Spain, Britain, and Germany were closing their borders against one of the largest migrant crises in centuries. The destabilization of Libya saw hundreds of thousands of African people seek asylum in Europe. This very conflict resulted in renewed slavery of African people forced into chains and free labor in the 21st century. Euro-American politics of borders and keeping the foreigners away were at the center of a new rising global order. Many people called it the return of fascism. They destabilized countries in the Middle East and Africa through brutal wars, and yet set out to build high walls to keep migrants of the very stranded countries away. It is therefore not shocking that China itself, when pressed under the crisis of pandemic which originate in their own country, could turn on the most vulnerable African migrants, blame them, and seek to cleanse their communities of black bodies. In Guangzhou, coronavirus is associated with black bodies. The reality is that this is also how Africa treats itself. Colonization, as Fanon explained, created the condition in which we look at ourselves through the eyes of the colonizers. When we see ourselves, when we see each other, we see the indignity and animality that the colonizer sees when they look at us. This is why the leadership of independent African countries has failed to break the chains that imprison the African mind. In the hands of their own leaders, Africans receive the same animal treatment that they get from China, Europe, and North America. When Africans criticize their leadership for corruption, nepotism, and dictatorship, the African leadership subjects them to the same brutal massacres, imprisonments, and brutality that manifested in other countries. The African migrants receive the same treatment we see in China, right here in South Africa. In Cape Town, African migrants who occupied the church for asylum were forced out by the city without any public outrage. In fact, each year, South Africans, together with their ANC leadership in government, engage in annual theaters and orgies of xenophobic violence against Nigerians, Zimbabweans, Congolese who live amongst us. From time to time, the African migrants put down or destroyed. The South African Police Service leads countless raids on those it calls undocumented migrants who happen to be Africans all the time. They beat them, arrest them, transport them to the borders. All this happens without any public outrage. Today, people are everywhere on social media, outraged by what Chinese are doing, rightfully so. Yet this is precisely what they do to other Africans right here in South Africa. They celebrate and encourage forced removals and deportation of African migrants right here in South Africa. The African body will never be treated with dignity far away when it fails to find a treatment of dignity here at home. The Chinese do to Africans what Africans do to each other here in Africa every day. This must tell us, all of us, that freedom cannot be realized in a single African country. No single African person can say they are free and hope to earn equal respect from the rest of the world when other Africans live in chains and indignity. African freedom means the freedom of all Africans wherever they are in the world. There is no South African freedom, peace and prosperity that can ever be achieved without the freedom, peace and prosperity of the whole African continent and diaspora. When financial and economic relief was communicated by President Ramaphosa, there was no mention of the continent and or all the African migrants who live amongst us. The food parcels and all grants are meant for South Africans only. Even the small businesses grants are structured for South Africans only. The migrants, even those who are registered with permanent residency, will be overlooked, excluded, and probably even deported during this COVID-19 crisis. This is the reason all other countries in the world will never see black lives as worthy of dignity, respect, and remorse. We do not feel remorse to each other right here on the continent. We do not feel solidarity for each other. Do you think small and big business of British citizens will not get tax relief from SARS? Do you think they will not get payment holidays from Standard Bank? Do you think the British citizens in America will not get financial help from the USA government? The answer is simple. They will, because white people look out for each other, and our own government loves white people more than black people. They see it as their duty to keep white people happy and safe, even at the expense of Africans in general. In all these interventions, in particular, interventions that provide food and temporary shelter for the most vulnerable of our people, we must not forget our brothers and sisters from neighboring countries who remain in our country during these difficult times. We must shelter everyone. We must feed everyone. We must make sure that everyone, despite their nationality, whether they have documentation or not, no one should find himself or herself without food because they are from Zimbabwe, Malawi, Lesotho, Botswana, Nigeria, and everywhere else in Africa. They are our own brothers and sisters. We must share the little we have in these times of crisis. Build our solidarity and unity with our African brothers and sisters in Africa, and all poor nations must receive our support. Our public health care in African continent is, as it is the case here in South Africa, it is broken and serves the few rich. There are countries that have less than 10 ventilators that are much needed during this period to fight COVID-19. Those that seems to have more, these medical equipment are concentrated in facilities that services the few. Other countries like Somalia do not have even a single ventilator. When we manufacture ventilators, masks, and all essentials, we must always think of our brothers and sisters in the African continent. Intensive care units is even far much less. The World Health Organization estimated that 44 countries in Africa have a total of 5,000 intensive care units. We must share both intellectual and physical infrastructure with African countries and all poor nations. We should be inspired by Cuba's medical internationalism guided by socialist values, values that put lives before profit at all times. We must all be grateful for the visionary leadership of Commandant Fidel Castro, who started Cuban medical internationalism more than 60 years ago. We thank the Cuban doctors who have gone to the front line and fight coronavirus. We salute, we also want to welcome them to South Africa. All interventions, including supporting industrialization and protection of our economy, must also take into account the much larger role South Africa must play in the African continent. All interventions to open the new kind of economy must open up the African economy before opening up to the West and Asia. All interventions that seeks to provide personal protection equipment must do so for our health workers here in South Africa and, where possible, for other African countries that do not have them. All interventions that seeks to ensure adequate supply of medicines and other necessary supplies to fight coronavirus here in South Africa must do so with Africa in mind. We condemn the cutting of the World Health Organization funding by Donald Trump. He must not politicize the COVID-19 and come to the party to save the world from this invisible enemy. We will not win the war against coronavirus here in South Africa while the rest of the continent and poor nations are losing the battle because we'll achieve nothing. We want to urge our governments and governments across the world to prioritize human life over profit and egos at this time. We want to remind our government that there is no economy without people, and any easing of economy to combat the spread of coronavirus must be based on the science and not profit. We salute our doctors, nurses, police, soldiers, petrol attendants, shopkeepers, and the frontline staff for your sacrifices. You are our real heroes. South Africans, please continue to stay at home. South Africans, continue to wash your hands. Hasta la victoria siempre. Victory is certain. I thank you.